Good day to you. My name is Lauren Paramore. Along with my colleague at University of Cape Town and People's Health Movement South Africa, I co-authored the case study that Heinrich Pool Foundation commissioned on COVID-19 vaccine access in South Africa. One way to summarize the situation in South Africa is to say that the government has secured sufficient doses to vaccinate 60% of the population. It's done so through bilateral deals with Pfizer and Johnson & Johnson. And if we stop here, it might seem that that's a fairly good situation. However, what we've seen in recent days is that it's in fact a quite precarious situation. And I say that in light of the contamination of Johnson & Johnson vaccines that took place at its Baltimore manufacturing plant. And so this has significantly impeded the vaccination rollout in South Africa. And I think it's also illustrated quite dramatically the consequences of the limited manufacturing base for COVID-19 vaccines globally. And so it's in light of the artificial supply constraint created by limited manufacturing sites for COVID-19 vaccines that we in our case study call strongly for the global community to support the COVID-19 intellectual property waiver submitted by India and South Africa in October 2020 at the World Trade Organization, and subsequently supported by many, many more member states of WTO. In particular, we call for the waiver to be supported in its full form, so in other words, to be supported for IP waivers with respect to vaccines, but also diagnostics and therapeutics, and also for the waiver to apply not only to patents, but also to trade secrets, copyrights, and industrial design. And so this is not something that's sufficient. Alongside this, there should be political pressure to ensure that greater equitable distribution of existing vaccines in the supply pool takes place. But certainly we believe that a core component of increasing vaccine equity is to ensure that more states in the global south are able to build their manufacturing capacity for COVID-19 vaccines during this pandemic, but also for future pandemics. And in this light, the legal certainty created by the TRIPS waiver is an important step, an important first step towards that outcome. Thank you.